Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea during a 60-second elevator ride.
Time's up.
Oh my gosh, I messed up.
If the pitch fails...
Let's do this. Let's vote.
It looks like nobody wants to invest. Send them down.
Going down.
Oh my God!
And if the pitch is successful...
Peter, you and I agree. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the board.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes! I love elevator pitch.
The judges face off to get the investment.
I'll do what he'll do, but I'll take 4%.
You're trying to mess up our deal?
Which deal you want? Us or him?
Now what you're going to do is destroy this entire opportunity.
Is the next billion-dollar company on its way up? It's Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch, presented by Sprint Business, with support from The Hartford, Paper and Packaging, How Life Unfolds. And this episode is funded by G2, America's number one selling, longest lasting gel pen, and the $100,000 G2 Overachievers Grant.
Going up.
Today's pitches are by entrepreneurs who are doing good through their businesses. Let's hear the first pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name's Emma Rose Cohen, and I'm the CEO and founder of Final. Single-use plastics are a disaster, polluting our lands, waterways, and harming cute sea creatures. I'm sure you guys have all seen the video of the turtle with the straw stuck up its nose. This is unacceptable, and it's what inspired me to create Final. Our first product, Final Straw, is a reusable, collapsible straw that fits in your keychain. So it goes where you go, and you can bring it anywhere. We're making sustainability fun, sexy, and easy. In the first 9 months of our business, we sold 200,000 reusable straws and prevented 27 million straws from entering the environment. This trend is spreading into legislative efforts and corporations, and we want to be at the forefront. We're asking for $500,000 in a convertible note to help us be the Tupperware of the 21st century.
Five.
Up next,
four,
we've got Final Four.
Three.
Thank you for
two,
listening.
One. Time's up.
She's sold 200,000 units.
Yeah.
I like it because of the fact that you can travel with it. You can put it into the little case versus the glass straws.
Okay, so there's the product, but what is she asking? I want to make sure that we're clear.
$500,000 on a convertible note.
On a convertible note.
And once again, nobody telling us what the cap or valuation is.
No.
I would honestly like to know more, though, because she does have sales.
Well, that's why we have our trusty
devices
to vote.
Let's vote.
Pete, it looks like you and I agree on this one. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Hey guys.
Hello.
Thank you.
Hello.
I brought some samples.
Thank you very much.
I've got teal, purple,
blue. I will go teal.
Black.
I like your packaging.
Yeah. Thank you.
How do you clean these?
Each case comes with a telescoping cleaning brush included.
Oh, right on.
Yeah.
So you said you sold 200,000 of these straws already in 9 months.
Yeah.
Well, what's the cost of the straw?
To the consumers, it's $24.50.
Are you saying that you've had $5 million in sales?
In the first 9 months. Yeah. Almost $5
million. Almost $5 million in 9 months.
Yes.
Oh, sorry, I was going to say, what is your immediate business plan?
So we just started expanding into wholesale. We are primarily direct-to-consumer, but the big idea is to create more products. So we want to create an entire line of products that we're calling Foreverables. We want to make it sexy, badass, fun to use, easy to clean, and so the next product is Final Fork.
What is your background? You know a lot about this.
I actually studied neuroscience in my undergrad and then did a big pivot and got a job at Los Alamos National Laboratory, worked in waste minimization for 5 years, and did my master's in sustainability at Harvard.
That's fantastic.
Impressive.
This is my first company, so I need advisors. I need people to help me figure out and navigate the way.
What's the valuation of your note?
20. It sounds,
20 million.
Yes.
And you've raised no money prior to this.
Zero.
I want to make you an offer.
Okay.
Because I love you.
Thanks.
And I love the concept. I love the straw. And I love supporting female founded companies. What about 250,000 on a convertible note?
I'm going to throw my hat in the ring as well. I'll give you the $500,000, but I want $1 million back. And for every straw that you sell, I want $5 until my money's paid back, and I'll only take the 2% equity in the company.
That's very
that would be my offer.
I'll match his deal. because
this happens every single time.
Because I bring more value to this than Pete does.
Yeah.
With my friends that are social media influencers, we could blow this thing up in a heartbeat.
I mean, you guys are nothing compared to what I can do for this lady. I'm gonna throw my wild card in.
Wow.
And I want to partner with Lindsay on this. Because what she needs is advisors.
I would take that deal.
Okay, I will do it for zero equity. I will give you $500,000, pay me back $1 million. We'll figure out it'll be a couple bucks a straw, maybe somewhere between 3 and 5, and call it a day.
I really appreciate your offer, but I could never do a royalty deal at this early stage.
Okay.
I liked your first offer.
So your first offer was what?
$250,000 on a convertible note.
I'll do $250,000 at a $10 million valuation. Call it a day. You have three deals on the table. My final deal now is $250,000 at a $10 million valuation, and you're gonna get myself and my partner to bust our butts to help blow this company up. You have another offer on the table that is Lindsay, $250,000 at the $20 million cap, or the combination of Randy and Lindsay plagiarizing my idea of the $500,000 investment paid back at $1 million with a 2% kicker. Which of those three offers do you want?
I'm so appreciative. Thank you so much. I would love to work with you, Lindsay. I got a deal with Lindsay, and I'm so excited because she's exactly who I wanted to work with. I think she really got the product. I had a feeling she would. So I'm over the moon excited, and I think it just goes to show that if you find a passion, believe in it, you can crush it, because it's just a straw.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
When I was pregnant with my first child, my husband's family told me not to bother having a gender reveal party. Why? Well, in his large family, there hadn't been a baby girl born in almost 20 years. So I had them put their money where their mouths were, and with $20 guesses, I was able to raise over $1,000 in a few weeks. I gathered a few of my pregnant friends, had them do the same, and they were each able to put money in the bank to offset the staggering cost of growing a family. Hi, my name is Kimberly Jolasun, and I'm here seeking $100,000 for 5% equity in my company. GenderRevealGame.com is the first product in a suite that aims to do three things: help moms raise money, save money, while providing quality maternal health information. How? We're gamifying motherhood. Since our launch just 5 months ago, we've already hosted 500 games and connected thousands of family members.
I just don't think that's a big business.
Having a baby is expensive, and with the need for preventative care clear than ever, join me in revolutionizing modern motherhood. Thank you.
One, time's up.
A bit confused by what she's selling us. Is it a website where a couple can register and then their families go on this website and play a game? Does the game come to your home? How does it work?
We need clarification. I think the market in terms of like gender reveal, that's a trending thing, which is people really like that.
Yeah.
I always look in a company, does it make or save people money?
Right.
You know? In this, it's saving families because it is expensive, you know, six kids.
So I guess the question is, none of us really have a full understanding of what she's doing,
right.
But does anybody have enough interest to find out more or not?
That $2 million valuation is a steep one.
Did she have any revenues?
We don't know.
You know what? It's time to vote.
She's onto something really big here. So let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Yes, thank you. Welcome.
Hello.
Oh my God, so happy to be here. Thank you so much.
You talked about many things.
Right.
Helping families, gender reveal, saving money.
Right.
Tell us about one thing that you do. Tell us about one thing that you do. And you also spoke about gamification.
Right.
So what is it that you do?
Okay, so this first product, so we're going to have a suite of products, but this very first one, our initial one, helps moms raise money by using that milestone of the gender reveal. So what happens is a mom goes on our platform, she creates a game, and in that game, she sets what the winning prize will be, she sets what the minimum vote will cost. Once her game is created, she sends the link to her family and friends. They go on the link, they click the link, they go on the game, and they guess whether they're having a boy or a girl. The mom could give clues if she likes. They guess and they pay with that guess. So at the end of the game, one random winner is selected from those who guessed right to win a prize, and then all proceeds then go to the expecting family.
So how do you make money in this?
Right now we take a transaction fee of 9% at the end of each game. And then we're growing our revenue streams to partner with mommy brands and baby brands. We plan on keeping moms until the baby arrives. And in that time we will be making money by affiliates and partnerships and branding.
Smart.
Interesting.
So can you tell me about who is your development team? Who's making the platform for you? What does that look like?
Right now, the MVP, the first game, is a web app. So it lives online as a web app. I used a dev shop for the first game to prove the concept. I just onboarded a CTO, two CTOs, and a front-end developer to join the team to help grow this game, as well as start planning out the second one.
Well, you had three people that voted no. You had the gaming expert of the United States of America that voted yes. So
That's a pretty big accolade, but
either she sees something that none of us do, or she just had to learn more because this is her world.
Yeah, no, I'm very interested. I think you have an amazing concept and a part of the market that hasn't been addressed. I'm very concerned about your team. Who is your technology team? Because we know that it's a whole long trail between an idea and the implementation of a great product, specifically if you're doing a mobile game or a mobile app. So that's the only reservation that's holding me back.
Right. So right now it has been me up until this point.
Yeah.
It has been me, and I've been using contractors to kind of build this thing.
That's a slippery slope.
It is. And
it's
which
a
is
very
why
slippery slope.
That's where I need the help in terms of the concept and the game and the relationship with the moms that I'll have. It's just the technology to really like grow and scale this. I mean, 500 games, our moms have raised $60,000 in total right now. So it's a great concept and they love it. It's just now about building it out. Help me build the team.
I mean, I think you were asking, what, 100K for what,
5%? 5%, yeah.
Yeah, and I think that that's just like you're way too
$2
early.
$2 million
way
valuation.
Too early to even be asking for that at this point. But I see the vision on how you can connect to a certain part of the market that's really critical that hasn't been addressed. So here's my offer. How about 50K for 10% of your company? So what do you think of that?
I'll take it.
Wow!
I got a deal. If she could help us with the tech, then we could take this thing to a whole nother level. I mean, our moms love us, so now we could just serve them so much more.
And now, Perfecting the Pitch, presented by Paper and Packaging, how life unfolds.
Go for engagement.
While potential investors are being pitched, one way to stand out is by being interactive. To get the investors interacting with you, bring your product and let them try it. Ask investors questions that require more than a yes or no answer. Consider bringing a paper presentation board or flip chart to draw pictures and map out details and plans in real time. The more tangible your pitch, the more likely it will spark an interest.
The more I'm interested, the better.
Paper and Packaging, how life unfolds. Visit howlifeunfolds.com.
Are you guys ready? I'm ready for the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, everyone. My name's Josh Cliffords. I'm the creator of Freeubi. We're launching the world's first free supermarket this winter, and our first product is free alkaline water that pays you to drink it. Freeubi members will receive free alkaline water in eco-friendly cans and cartons, free delivery, and 10 cents from every unit will be donated to charity to build water wells for people in need. When you do the math, we only need 10% of Americans to stop paying for bottled water so we could build water wells for 1 billion people. And even though our product is discounted at 120%, we still earn a minimum of 20 cents per every unit we freely distribute. Since the product is free, everything's paid for by ads. But it's not just any ads, because when you use your smart device, you'll see individualized commercials, breaking news, you could shop, order food directly to your door, download music, movies, TV shows, video games, and software. In the US, the ad industry is worth more than $200 billion a year, and we are here to ask for $500,000 in investment for a safe note.
2, 1, time's up.
I wish you would have said it, what cap on the safe.
Interesting concept. He's trending in the right way. Interested.
We invested in a company just recently that's doing advertisements with a fancy type of video projection on cars. Because, and he's just saying, I'm going to be putting ads on
a can
of water.
It's conscious capitalism. Water's huge. We gotta save some sea turtles here.
Okay.
So
I say we vote.
Yeah.
See
I say
if
we
it makes
vote.
Sense to bring them up.
It looks like all four of us love this guy. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Hey, you guys, thank you so much.
Welcome.
Hey.
I brought a couple prototypes for you guys. Sorry I don't have four. Our labels will be much more vibrant and higher quality. So, we're launching the world's first free supermarket. What I'm explaining to you works for anything that could be manufactured cheaply. Water, soda, beer. However, the second generation of our software will allow anyone in the United States to earn a minimum of $15 per hour engaging with individualized commercials. And so, this right here is our MVP. We're pre-launch. Will be launched this holiday. We recently just signed a contract for distribution in more than 1,100 pet shops around the United States. Each one wants a minimum of 5,000 units per month.
Do you have those agreements done?
Yes.
Are they signed?
Yes.
They are?
Yes.
And is there revenues coming in? Do you have?
We're pre-launch. We're launching this winter.
In December?
Yeah.
So what's your background? I'm interested in you. This is conscious capitalism. Why are you so passionate about this?
I've always liked helping people. I was a personal trainer for athletes. I was in the military.
What's your why?
Because
other than
when we sell free food and water globally, we'll save 100,000 lives a day.
Okay, so it's about saving lives at the end of the day.
Of course.
Okay.
That's how all businesses should be.
Let's talk about the money real quick. What's your cap on the safe?
So, to be honest, this is extremely this is extremely profitable. And so $500,000, we got this Indiegogo campaign come up, and we got some celebrities and athletes that are going to be backing us. And so that's going to be really successful. But $500,000 is going to allow us to manufacture a minimum of 17 million units the first year.
What's the cap on the safe? Answer the question.
We want to do a one-time raise.
So you think $500,000 is going to be all you're going to need to grow this thing going forward?
We're planning on breaking the crowdfunding record as well.
Okay, I think there's an important distinction here. If this is a one-time raise, let's say this is the only money you'll need to raise, what is the price? Forget about cap, forget about everything. What's the price?
Well,
What's the value?
We could give you 10%.
Okay, so you're saying it's a $5 million valuation.
We got numerous revenue streams, but the money that we're looking for is to get into manufacturing.
How is that $500,000 going to be allocated across your needs?
$500,000 will get us more than $17 million in production. It'll get us a warehouse. It'll allow me to put the CEO on salary. We have some really good dev team that's working for free. I could give them a little butt bucks. I'll pay everyone before myself.
So basically 10% for $500,000. And then it sounds like a lot of the other vendors you're going to have work, they're willing to donate their time for that.
Well, it's not a donation for them because they're going to get amazing PR because they're going to be indirectly getting a ton of advertising and they're going to be indirectly building water wells and saving the world.
We unfortunately are going to have to call this one, but I can tell you where my head is at. Just for feedback, number one, I still don't fully understand what you're doing. So it's not just all over the place. I'm trying to follow it. I don't fully get it, and that's a huge problem. The second thing is, I don't know if you've thought through your financing, because when you talk about an only one-time raise, you wouldn't do a safe, because a safe only works that converts into the next qualified financing. I mean, even like talking about your dollar amount valuation, you were hesitating. And this is something I'm gonna be passing on. If anybody else wants to make an offer, this is the time.
Here's my feedback. If you don't have your strategy on one page, you don't have a strategy. I think when you're not only raising capital, but when you're going to your vendors and your things, I'd just be really crystal clear on what your execution plan is. It'll be a lot more believable. I hope you do awesome. So.
Well, thanks.
So my feedback is you're right on in terms of what people are looking for, socially conscious brands, they want social impact. However, I had trouble understanding what your go-to-market strategy was. Once you guys clarify that, I think you'll be very successful.
Today, I think it's too early for me to personally invest in this.
Unfortunately, it doesn't look like we're going to have a deal today.
But it's okay. Well, thank you for your time.
Thank you for your time. And we all wish you massive success.
Thank you.
Well, I guess I was a little bit nervous, so didn't explain the product as well as I could. The beauty with this project is we're profitable from the first unit we give away, and so most companies can't say that. They just weren't interested, so it's, in my opinion, their loss.
I am very excited.
I've been working on my pitch a lot, and I think I'm ready.
Time for the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
There are more than 200 million women on Pinterest, but hardly any of them are actually making money from it. I'm Rachel Ngome, and I'm the person who teaches women how to profit from Pinterest. I take women who have hobbies and teach them how to be entrepreneurs. I take moms who have full-time jobs and help them stay home with their babies. This is what I do, and I'm really good at it. In the past 2 years, our online programs have generated over $875,000 in revenue. In the next 2 years, with your help, that number will be $11 million. I'm asking for $250,000 for a 5% investment, and I use that money for customer acquisition. I have a $71 customer acquisition cost, and those customers will generate $5.5 million in revenue annually. Our company is about so much more than just making money. It's about making a real difference in the world. We work with purpose-driven entrepreneurs who donate millions of dollars to charities all around the world, just like our family does. I truly believe that as entrepreneurs, the more money you make, the greater impact you can have.
Time's up.
Again, I have no idea what she does. Teaches people how to sell on Pinterest.
It's very specific.
It is very specific.
I get it. And Pinterest didn't start to make money until a few years ago, as you know.
I wish she would have talked about it in the other direction, that I created this online platform that empowers people to get learnings this way.
Yes.
We're doing this with Pinterest. We can do this with everything else.
Can it be worked with Instagram? And
she went from, we're going to make you better on Pinterest. And by the way, you know,
and was she specific on her cause?
I'm not even sure what the cause is. Nah. It's helping people sell stuff on Pinterest.
There's a lot of questions, but the thing that I do like, she did 875,000 in sales.
Yeah, going on 11 million, she
said? Going on 11 million, so what do you think?
I don't know.
I think we need a vote.
Okay, let's vote.
It looks like nobody wants to invest. Send her down.
Going down.
Oh!
If I could do it again, maybe explain a little bit more about the programs that we offer and how we're really giving back and contributing on a greater scale. I think we'll be fine and we'll figure it out. I figured it out for the past 2 years, so we'll be good.
Coming up on the next Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Suit and tie cannabis guy.
It's like Men in Black.
We're raising $15 million for 30% of our company.
Are you sure you're not smoking that stuff?
To apply for season 6, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.